Hello everyone, good morning to all of you. This is Kavita ma'am, welcomes you all to our English class. Again, we are going to continue our chapter Madam Rides the Bus, written by Valli Kannan, and this story is translated from Tamil by K.S. Sundaram, as I told you. So students, in our previous chapter, we learned how the author Valli Kannan tries to present a world as seen from a child's perspective. And who is child here? Valli, a 8-year-old girl. So we are seeing the two main aspects of world or two main aspects of life from the outlook, from the approach or from the perspective of Valli, a little girl. We found till now we have read that how Valli was enjoying her ride or her journey on a bus. And she was so smart, and she was overjoyed to see the nature, the canal, the palm trees, grassland, distant mountains, the blue sky, the great stretch of green field as far as the eye could see. She also overjoyed when she saw a cow running with her race tail on the road ahead of the bus. So these were the various beautiful scenes which she encountered while her journey from her village to the town. But when she starts her journey back to her village from the town, she is confronted with a serious, a sad incident due to which she was moved from within. While returning, she noticed that the body of the same cow was crushed and bleared, and she was so much disappointed and disheartened by this scene. Although the bus kept moving, but she was trying to understand the meaning of life and death in her own terms, and that's why she became silent. But just a while before, she was very, very active in her manner, in her gesture, in her talk, and the way she was retaliating back to the conductor, to her co-passengers from time to time, we have seen over the chapters till now. But now Valli became silent completely. So we shall start and continue our today's content, page number 125, and the last four lines here I go. The bus moved on. The bus didn't stop. The girl, Valli, she was shocked. She was surprised and astonished to see the dead cow lying with blood all over, and its eyes seemed lifeless. The memory of the dead cow haunted her, dampening her enthusiasm. She no longer wanted to look out of the window. So this was the reaction which immediately came to her, and she was, until now, she was very much interested in looking out of the window, and she was delightful. She was extracting pleasure out of the scene outside, but the sight of the dead cow dampened her enthusiasm, and she became disheartened. Not only that, when the bus had moved far from that scene, even then she was not able to forget that sight, and the memory of the dead cow kept haunting the mind of this little girl. That means she was again and again repeatedly thinking about that dead cow. So that means, it means that Valli was now trying to understand the nature of the death. She was trying to understand that it is not only about happiness, it is not only about delightfulness or joyful things in the life, but a person has to face death too. So this real fact was being understood by this girl for the very first time while returning from her journey back to her village. She sat thus glued to her seat. See, glued to her seat, glued, a fabric stick, you have heard, fabric stick, which is a glue. So glued is a past tense, so we can say it as stuck. So Vali didn't made any kind of movement and she remained stuck to her seat until the bus reached her village at 3:40. So Vali had returned around 3:40, and it was the time when she knew that her mother might be sleeping or having her sleep. So she had reached her village on right time. Now she stood up and stretched herself. Then she turned to the conductor and said, "Well, sir, I hope to see you again." So students, see, Vali is so excited and so hopeful. Although we saw that she became sad, she became disappointed and disheartened a little while ago. But while leaving the bus, while departing from the bus, she bid farewell to the conductor, saying that she would see him again. That means she was positive to have a ride on the bus again. She wanted to ride on the bus again because she liked that journey. She had enjoyed that journey. So she turned towards the conductor and replied him in a positive manner. But before that, what she did, when she stood up from her seat, she stretched her body. So children, when we wake up from our sleep, from long sleep, from the whole night sleep, our body becomes lazy, lethargic, and we don't feel like getting up from the bed. So, and what we do, we just stretch our body, we just stretch our arms and our back and chest, every part of our body to make us more active. So here Vali was again behaving like an adult man who stretches his body after a long sleep overnight. So here again it is reflected, the behavior, the manner of Vali is showing as if she was behaving like an adult. "Okay, madam," he answered her smilingly. "Whenever you feel like a bus ride, come and join us, and don't forget to bring your fare." So conductor, being a jovial nature man, again called him, again addressed him as madam, and he said that's fine. And he was looking forward for Vali to come for a bus ride again and to join them, because he too enjoyed his journey with this girl. Because throughout the journey, the conductor and the co-passengers got an opportunity to amuse themselves. That's why he said that yes, whenever she would feel like, she can have a bus ride and join them. And at the same time, he further added that she must not forget to bring her fare. Why he asked this sentence, or why he stated this sentence of fare? Because we found that Vali, when she boarded the bus, before entering into the bus, she had stretched her hand with coins to the conductor, saying that this is your fare. And before she began her journey, return journey, she again gave the remaining 30 paise fare to the conductor without being asked by conductor for it. So that's why conductor again wanted to make her laugh, and that was the only reason he asked her to bring fare. Although the intention of the conductor was not to earn money, but it was just a fun, and out of fun he simply said this sentence to Vali. She laughed and jumped down from the bus, then away she went, running straight for home. And instead of moving here and there, loitering in the streets, she directly moved to her home, because she knew that she has to reach her home on time so that she can again go for such kind of bus rides in future. When she entered her house, she found her mother awake and talking to one of Vali's aunts, the one from South Street. This aunt was a real chatterbox, never closing her mouth. See, we are talking about Vali's aunt, who was a real chatterbox, never closing her mouth once she started talking. So when Vali reached her home, she found two women. One of them was her mother, and another woman with whom her mother was talking or having conversation with was her aunt, and that aunt lived where? In the South Street. She was living in a neighborhood, and she found both her mother and Wali and her aunt talking to each other. So she was not at all surprised to see her mother awake. She remained very calm and smooth and normal. And what the author is telling us about this aunt, that she was a real chatterbox. Real chatterbox means a very talkative person, one who talks uninterrupted or regularly without any stoppage, without shutting mouth. Then that person is known as real chatterbox. So this aunt of Wali was a real chatterbox. She was a very talkative woman, and she was talking with her mother when Wali entered her house. So the aunt was a real chatterbox, never closing her mouth. She had a habit of talking so much that she never shut her mouth. Once she started talking, so continuously she would blah 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 blah. "And where have you been?" said her aunt when Wali came in. She spoke very casually, not expecting a reply. So Wali just smiled, and her mother and aunt went on with their conversation. So she found both the women having conversation, but her aunt interrupted. Wali's aunt interrupted her by throwing a question that where she had been till now. She was not seen anywhere. But without expecting, without waiting for the answer, for the reply from Wali, as she was a talkative lady, she didn't wait for the answer from Wali, because it was a formal question and not an intentional one. So that lady, that aunt, kept on talking with the mother without waiting for any answer. So she spoke very casually, not expecting a reply. And Wali took the advantage. She didn't even want to reply this answer. She also found that as this lady will keep on talking, will not shut her mouth, so she didn't bother to answer her even. She didn't bother to reply her aunt, because she didn't want to disclose about her recent journey. And her mother, so Wali just smiled, and her mother and aunt went on with their conversation. So the conversation kept going between her mother and aunt, and Wali reached her home safely. So students, this is all for your today's content. We shall finish the chapter in our next video, and I will post you 2 questions in your Scholar ERP app. So complete those questions. Keep updating your work. Don't delay. And once the schools are open, your notebooks will be checked. Fine. And keep revising the chapters too. And if you have any doubt, then you can consult me anytime. Thank you. Bye-bye.